Hi, my name is Kim Koski. I'm a drifting driver driving in the Finnish Drifting Championship, and today I'm going to show you how you can install your new GearMotive ZF Dogbox.
The first and foremost thing you have to check is that you have the correct clutch discs for your input shaft, so that you have the correct spline. The GearMotive Dogbox comes with three alternatives. You can either get the 35 mil large 10 spline axle, the smaller 10 spline, as well as the GM 26 spline, which this one right here is. So before you do anything else, you check that your clutch discs have the same spline. I have my clutch already installed, but I checked this beforehand. And next, we are going to measure that the splines on the input shaft actually use all of the splines on the clutch discs. You take first this measurement, which is 96 millimeters. Then you measure to the bottom of your spline. Bottom of your spline, which is 56, about 56 mil. So 96 minus 56, that's 40 mil. And then you measure the same on your gearbox, which is in my case 39, which means that we have 1 mil spare. The axle goes 1 millimeter over or through the clutch discs, so we're okay. So now that we have checked that our input shaft goes all the way through and uses all the splines of our clutch discs, we can go ahead and measure the tolerance or the clearance for the throwout bearing. So how much clearance you have between the throwout bearing and your clutch right here. Then one of the most important steps is to make sure that your surface of the engine block is completely clean where your gearbox goes to the block. And also very important that you have these centering pieces here. Okay, so now we have this installed, and the next step is to put the engine in the car and connect the prop shaft as well as the rear mount of the transmission. So let's get to it. Okay, now we have the engine and gearbox package installed. Let's start from the gearbox mounts. The gearbox mount should always be softer than your engine mounts. So in my case, I have aluminium engine mounts, and I use rubber gearbox mounts. This eliminates the twisting effect between the rear of the gearbox and the engine. So it enables the gearbox to follow the engine's movements without putting excess stress on the casing. Next would be the breather hose. I already installed the breeder hose. This comes from GearMotive when you order your gearbox. So you simply have to put a regular oil hose or fuel hose from this and pull it up to the engine bay. I will show you a short video from there. Okay, so here's what the breeder looks like from the engine bay. I use a normal fuel filter, which works as a catch can. To be sure, this should be a bit larger, maybe a deciliter or so. But this has worked fine for me, and I have never seen any oil coming out of this. This also enables the oil to run back down to the gearbox after a long pull. Then, when you have the gearbox installed, I also recommend that you put your rubber coupling, or of course, if you have the prop shaft adapter, you should also put that on first, and then make your shifter linkage. So the shifter linkage should be straight in the hose center, according to the gearbox. But also, it should not have too much of an inclination. So for example, this point should not be very much higher than the other point on the gearbox. In this case, where you have the 110mm rubber coupling, you have to have a bit of inclination, otherwise it will touch the rubber coupling here, since this gearbox is originally made for a 96mm rubber coupling. Moving on to the prop shaft fastening. So in my case, I use a prop shaft adapter, which enables an easy swap between the GS5, which I earlier used, and this GearMotive gearbox. And this is a simple bolt-on feature, which you can use the same prop shaft for the GS5, which means it converts it from 96mm, puts it a bit backwards, and you can use either 110 or 105mm rubber couplings. But let's go through, if you don't have this prop shaft adapter, always use rubber couplings. Do not use aluminium ones with polyurethane ones. If you use 96mm, always use the M3 version. This is heavy duty, and it will withstand the forces very well, and you should not have any issues with that. Then if you have the prop shaft adapter, which I have in this case, and I use the large 110mm rubber coupling, I always use some of the high-end heavy-duty stuff. Always check for wear or any signs of cracks or anything that you can notice. And I always change these once a year, even if I don't see any visual damage on them. Then moving on to the fasteners. So always use 10.9 or better bolts, and preferably with fine thread. So these are, for example, now M12 times 1.5, which are also original, or the same as OEM bolts. And it's also very important to use always new bolts when installing the prop adapter, and as well as the rubber coupling. I also like to use Nordlock washers. This way you don't, or the risk is minimized that the bolts will loosen from vibrations of the engine and the car itself. Okay, so one thing that I forgot to mention is that you also have to check that you put the rubber coupling facing the right way. So these have sort of a rotational direction,
And in my case, it says here set Gelenkwelle, which means that this side should go towards the prop shaft. This is typical in German because these are, at least mine is made in Germany, but however, check that your rubber coupling is facing the right way. Otherwise, you also might have premature failure of the rubber coupling.
Okay, now we have the prop adapter installed as well as the rubber coupling. Let's then look at what sort of requirements there are for the prop shaft. First of all, always use a two-piece prop shaft. Never use a one-piece prop shaft because it puts very, very, very much stress on the back of the gearbox. Also, warranty is void if using a one-piece prop shaft. And this can cause premature failure of the gearbox. Next step, you have your prop shaft done. It should be balanced, so make sure everything is in balance. Take it to a certified machine shop and make sure it's balanced. Next step would also be to check that the rubber centering piece of the prop shaft is in good condition, because this centers on the output shaft of the gearbox. So if it is in bad condition, you can have a slight wobble of the prop shaft, which can also cause failure of the rubber coupling. That's it for the prop shaft, and let's install it. Okay, now the prop shaft is installed, and using the same hardware as for the rubber coupling, so 10.9, fine thread, and no lock washers. I also like to put a small amount of thread locker, so I have thread locker on all the bolts regarding to the prop shaft, because this is a very, very critical point, and if it comes loose, it's gonna be an expensive repair. So when you have your prop shaft here, you can do this, or you should do this before. I have already done it, but you should make sure that the gearbox and the prop shaft is perfectly in line. So this can be done with, for example, some sort of lasers which you put on the output shaft and line it up with the bearing for the prop shaft. I've already done this, so this is now perfectly in line with the gearbox and will work a long time. Now you have the gearbox installed. The final thing to do is to put oil in your gearbox. GearMotive recommends 75W-140, and the amount used is between 1.5 to 2 liters. But you should always fill it until it reach this level hole, and then put the plug back in. When you have fill your oil, and you make sure that all mounts are secure, your prop shaft bolts are secure, you have checked all the previous things with the clutch and so on, then you can put your car on the ground and test it for the first time. Now the install is complete, and now there's nothing left to do than to try the gearbox out. Remember that during the first couple of kilometers there's a running period, so drive carefully and no sudden accelerations or clutch kicks during that time. After the braking period, change your oil and now you're ready to go. For more information regarding the gearboxes, visit GearMotive.com and see you out on the racetrack.